We shall now learn MVC data entry with jQuery and HTML5. In our previous exercise, we saw that MVC does allow us an AJAX based data entry form, but the problem is that file upload cannot be integrated into it. To integrate file upload through asynchronous upload, we need jQuery and HTML5 in combination with MVC. So let us see all the steps that are required for doing this. We will continue with the same example. So first of all, I will come to the Solution Explorer. You have to have a registration template. So this template is appearing here. The same template as we had in the previous case. The only difference is that for client-side validation, we have added a required is equal to required attribute here. This is meant for client-side validation. This is HTML5 based. So since our purpose is to get perfection with the input control for the file upload, we have added a client-side validation which was not available through MVC as we saw in the previous chapter. Next, no other change is required in this. Retain it as usual, make it as usual. Then we'll come to index.cshtml. Here what you have to do is, you have to create a form with html.beginForm, not AJAX, because AJAX will be done through jQuery. So a normal HTML form posting to index and home through post and anchor type and give it an ID so that it can be accessed through the jQuery. Then as usual, editor for model to display the form, and the submit button is replaced this time by an A tag. href is null JavaScript, so it won't be a normal A, just a link button that appears having an ID of A submit. We'll attach a click event handler to this in JavaScript. So this is the second thing that we have to do, that is put a simple form with an A tag here. Next, let us come to see the JavaScript side. This is the date picker that we had added last time. I can show you the code. So it is scripts jQuery function $validator date date picker, and here we can start typing the code for the click event of the A button that we have added above. So the ID is A submit, so $asubmit.click. Pick the form. Here we have simply added information that you can do some pre-validation on the file that has been selected by the user. There are a number of methods in HTML5 using jQuery. So those you can research on your own. We haven't added them to this one so as to keep the things simple. So if that is written, then you can simply show an alert and return back. If $form.valid, this is used to run the validators, so that client-side validations, as we have hooked through annotations, they continue to work. So the moment this function is called, a validation will occur, and if the form is valid, then you will move on to read the form data for the entire my form. This is my form, the ID that we gave. The form data this time includes the entire registration form, including the file submit also. So this means that the variable FD now contains the entire file as well as the data from the drop-down list, from the radio buttons and all. Remember that this is an HTML5 function, so this code will work only in browsers that support HTML5. And you have to take care that it is in IE 10